I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. I was going to walk and talk and talk to you about psychopathy and how I fit into psychopathy, but it's a little bit too rainy, so maybe not. Well, that was wetter than I thought it was going to be.
That's what she said.
It's raining quite hard. Apparently there's a storm coming, but who knows. Anyway, serious now. I'm not a sociopath. Although, if you were to talk to me, you might think that. Sociopathy at the moment is one of the talking points on YouTube, and that's because Shane Dawson is making a series about sociopaths regarding Jake Paul. And at the time of recording, the sixth part of this installment has not yet been released.
As you know, Shane Dawson is doing a documentary on Logan Paul's brother, Jake Paul, and it's titled The Dark Side of Jake Paul.
Shane Dawson is the king of YouTube.
Yeah.
These past couple of
months,
he's been kind of the king of YouTube for like past year or something.
And the first thing we're going to talk about today is one of the most requested stories from over the weekend, and that is Shane Dawson popped up back in the news because of his Mind of Jake Paul docuseries.
And I don't really talk about mental health on this channel. I don't really talk about me and my mental health. And not many people even know that I've got mental health problems, but it's true. And the reason I don't talk about it is because, well, to be honest, there's none of anyone's business. It's my mental health. Like, it's not because I feel ashamed or guilt from having issues. It's none of their business. But it's gotten to the point where my mental health is actually affecting my life in terms of motivation, in terms of drive, in terms of get up and go-ness of just me in general. The thing that affects me most of all is motivation. I find it very difficult to self-motivate. And the reason I find it difficult to self-motivate is because I don't have strong emotions towards doing things. I have emotions like love and sadness, things like that. But when it comes to fear and anxiety, I don't feel any of that. Which is fine, which is great. Not feeling fear and not feeling anxiety, why is that a bad thing at all? And I'll tell you why it's a bad thing. Because not only do I not feel fear and anxiety, I also don't feel excitement, which is an issue, because to be motivated towards doing something, generally it's because you're looking forward to doing it, excitement, or you have a fear of failure. And I don't have either of those things. So I don't have a fear of failure, so I'm not going to try and do something because I'm afraid of missing out or afraid of failing. And I don't have that striving passion towards trying to achieve something. It's a combination of those two things which makes motivation very difficult, because if I don't get a sense of joy or accomplishment out of doing something, or I don't feel fear or anxiety for not achieving something, then I don't really have much reason to do something. I don't feel kudos when I achieve something that I've been trying to do for a while. The other thing that I've struggled with is empathy, in a big way. I'm a very non-empathetic person when it comes to random people. I have a sense of empathy for those who are in my close vicinity, like really tight-knit circle of friends and family. But if you're slightly outside that circle of family or friends, then I just don't care. If I was to punch someone in the face, then I would feel bad because my action caused someone to be in pain. If I was standing next to someone and they were to be punched in the face and I see it happen and I could move them out the way or I could stop the punch from happening and they got hurt, I would know that my lack of action hurt them. So I feel remorse or guilt in that way, but I don't feel empathy. If two people who are randomly in the street were to beat each other up, I wouldn't feel bad for either one of them. I often go on like 4chan or something to the B-board or, you know, something like that, and try and see the wrecked thread to see if I have any sense of empathy. So I see someone getting burnt alive, I don't really feel anything inside. I'll give you some examples of my lack of empathy and you'll see how extreme it is. I lived next to two separate neighbours in two separate cities, two separate times in my life. The first next door neighbor I lived was an old man who used to get in at night, used to wake up quite early in the morning. He used to get a paper delivered on the sideboard of the block of flats that we used to live in, and used to grab his paper and go back to his house. And there was not much insulation in that building, so we could hear his keys go in and out. He comes in late one night, and I remember watching the television next to the front door, and I could hear him get in, and it was like, it was later than normal for him. It was like 2 o'clock in the morning. I thought that was quite late. He's had one at the social club, that's for sure. And the next morning I don't hear him get up, but I wasn't really paying attention, so I just assumed that he got up and left, because he hadn't come back for his newspaper for 4 days. And on the fifth day, I started thinking, Christ, maybe he's not actually gone. Maybe he isn't visiting friends or family. Maybe he's dead. And I said it like that. I said to my girlfriend at the time, I was like, I think he's dead. I think he's actually dead. And as I was saying that, well, not as I was saying it, but a couple hours into that day, I get a knock at the front door and I open it and it's a doctor. He said, do you mind if I let myself into the building and check on my patient? He hasn't gone to his appointment recently and I'm a bit worried for him, so I know he's quite ill. I went, yeah, sure. And let him into the building, and he knocked on the patient's door, went in, and he was dead. He was actually dead. And did I feel bad? No. I didn't even feel bad that he was dead for 5 days before anybody checked on him. No friends, no family, nobody came to him. The reason he wasn't picking up his post is because he had died that night. He came in really late, and I didn't feel bad. Now, hold your judgment on me until after I tell this next story, because I'm going to talk about why it's not my fault that I don't feel lack of empathy. The second story I have, again, is with a next door neighbour. I used to live next to a couple. They were about 60 or 70 years old. They lived above me, in the flat above. Different city, different town, different time, different girlfriend. I knew that his wife was quite ill, and I used to go and get my post, and every time I went to get my post, I would see her sometimes, and I would say, how are you feeling? She'd be like, yeah, I'm all good. I don't really care. I'm just making chit-chat to make it seem like I care. And I'd leave. And every time I bump into the husband, I always ask him, how's the wife doing? And he would always say, yeah, she's good. Then one night, it's about 3:30 in the morning, I'd gotten to sleep quite just a little bit before that. So I maybe went to sleep at about 2:30, 3 o'clock. And there was loads of noise outside my flat. Loads of noise. Doors opening and closing, car doors slamming, there was lights whirling in my room, and there was so much commotion going on that I was wondering what the hell is actually going on. The next morning, I see the husband and I say, how's the wife doing? And he said, yeah, last night she died. The first thing I said to him was, well, that sucks. Which, in hindsight, is not really a thing you should say to someone whose wife had just passed. It's not very civil. It's kind of rude. I didn't say anything rude to him, but it's just a bit rude to say that to him. The first thing I thought of after he told me was, oh, that explains the commotion last night. I didn't say that, obviously, because that would have been rude. But it was her getting into an ambulance after she had died. I didn't care. I wasn't empathetic towards him. I want to just briefly talk about how that's not my fault. It's not my fault that I don't feel empathy towards people who aren't in my immediate circle. If someone's got depression and you hear someone say something on the lines of, what have you got to be depressed about? There's nothing to be depressed, just get over it. It shows a lack of wisdom on their part. Because depression is an illness of how you feel, and it's an illness as real as like diabetes or cancer. You know, it's an illness, and you could be the most privileged person in the world. You could be born with a silver spoon shoved up your butt and it wouldn't make a difference. If you're depressed, you're depressed. And I think that this is very similar to that. I can't help the fact that I don't feel empathy towards people. I just can't help that fact. No matter what I try. And I think it's important for people to realize that just because you have a lack of empathy towards other people doesn't necessarily mean that A, you're a bad person, and it doesn't necessarily mean that B, it's your fault. I'm a Hufflepuff. If I was born in the Game of Thrones universe, I would be a Stark. Characters of TV shows and films that I closely like Ned Stark, Jon Snow, Captain America, Superman, they do things because it's right. They do the right thing just because. That's their thing. Which is what Hufflepuff is like. I'm not gonna span on why I'm a Hufflepuff. I have a very strong sense of you should do the right thing just because. So it doesn't mean that I'm a bad person. And this got me thinking about sociopaths. Am I a sociopath because of that? If I don't feel empathy towards another person, then am I a sociopath? And I decided, no, I'm not. And the reason I thought that is because sociopathy, you have to fall into a category of 7 traits. And I'll show you a still from a video by Katie Morton, link in the description box below if you want to learn more about it. These are the 7 things that you need to have in order to be considered a sociopath. Or you're supposed to have 3 or more of the following. And I don't have any of those. So I know that I'm not a sociopath, but I don't know what that leads me to be. Again, I shouldn't self-diagnose, but I feel like I'm fairly objective. And this is where this channel kind of comes into it. Because I don't have motivation towards doing things, I feel like it's because I don't feel fear, anxiety, or excitement, I have a very lack of motivation towards doing things. And now I'm getting my ass in gear because I feel like a sense of duty more than anything. Like, I have to do these things, otherwise I won't be able to afford a place to live. I won't be able to afford food. So it's kind of like a necessity that I need to do. I'm not motivated towards doing it. It's a thing that I need to do. So this channel is going to kind of follow the adventures of me trying to find something that I enjoy doing. Trying to either feel fear or feel anxiety or feel excitement towards doing something that is lacking in my life. Because the thing that I haven't mentioned actually, that I should probably mention, is that I remember the feelings of fear. I remember the feelings of anxiety or the feeling of excitement. And I think I was about 15 or 16 when I had a particularly bad day at school. And I was really sad. Really sad this day. And that was it. From there on, I didn't feel fear of anything. I didn't feel anxious about doing stuff. Nor do I feel excited. And as I said, fear and anxiety, not having that is fabulous. But not having excitement as well leads to some very difficult issues. So yeah. That's what I've been thinking recently. I'm very keen to know whether or not you guys have felt the same way as I have. So let me know in the comment section below. I know this has been a particularly long video and it's been draining and drawing out some stuff, but it's interesting, at least to me. Am I a sociopath? No. But there is something wrong. Let me know if you feel anything like similar to what I do. I'm very interested to see if, because I came out about this, that some people will follow my lead. Let me know in the comment section below. And of course, subscribe to the channel and be a member if you want to be a member, or join the Patreon page if you want to do that. There's loads of different things, and I'll see you again tomorrow when we talk about disability and lucid dreaming. Whether or not disabled people can lucid dream. Should be interesting. And until tomorrow, bye!